Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back. All right, playing as black today. Wish me luck. Playing the Caro here. Pretty standard stuff. I plan on playing this opening for a very long time. A lot of people give me a hard time about taking this knight. I think the engine actually recommends it, but I'm going to just try playing one game where I don't take that knight and just maintain the pin on it and see if I can get some more value out of the bishop, maybe. Maybe, maybe not. We'll see. Getting pretty close to 1,000. We're 43 points away, which is like 6. Like 6 or 7 wins, I think. Kind of want to go h6 to not get kicked here. I bring the knight out, the knight gets kicked, and then it's a bit awkward. If he pushes e5, might be good for me. I don't know. We'll see. Could bring the queen out to b6 here, attack the pawn. Could bring the dark square bishop out. I don't really like trading the dark square bishop out for the knight, though. I'm gonna try to plant the dark square bishop on c5. I don't know. I personally still kind of prefer taking the knight, but maybe that's just me. Gonna try something. I don't normally do this, but I might just bring the bishop back to c7. That might not be very good since it basically blocks the queen in from going b6, but we'll see. I was expecting that. I mean, I guess I can go one of two things. Go pin the knight or bring the bishop back. I don't know. Hard to say. I feel like just coming out here and paying the knight wastes a move. But then again, yeah, I don't know. It just forces his queen to develop. Or bringing it back. I don't really like the idea of bringing it back to c7 for some reason. Yeah, it feels like a waste of move doing that. Probably knight e7 next. And probably h6 at some point. I won't be surprised if he plays a3. Is that a mouse slip? Seems like a mouse slip. It's kind of weird, no? Yeah, I don't really understand that move. A4. I think it was a mouse slip. What's he looking for? Just brings the light square bishop out. He has a lot of stuff pointing this way. So, is it better to castle kingside? I don't know. I tend to like have some issues when I castle kingside with all this stuff kind of pointing towards the king here. But I don't know. Probably best to just develop here. I'm gonna do something with this guy eventually. Yeah, it's like, yeah, I could stack his pawns here, but is it really that valuable? I don't know. My guess is it's probably not that important. I think it's time to push c5. He can still give me the annoying check on b5 if I push my c5 pawn. I think we just castle. It's move 10. Whatever. I feel like he's going to play queen d2 next. I think he's going to play queen d2 or knight. Or knight g5. He didn't play knight g5. I was kind of expecting knight g5. Anything I should be particularly worried about at this point? Kind of want to block that in with the knight here. I think he's going to try to go knight g5. Kind of want to push h6 just to stop his knight from coming out there. Also, I could just go plain attack that queen. Maybe attacking the queen is more valuable here. The queen's probably better. Probably time to go knight f5, I imagine. His knight is pinned here, which is good for me. Thinking about how I can abuse that knight on c3. Probably can't really do anything at this point. Maybe that's the move there. Knight b6 d4, or c4, excuse me. Attack the queen, maybe. I'm gonna go for the trades. Kind of an idea there. I think this would stack his pawns on the e file, which I think would be pretty good. But we'd have to trade off this way, which I don't really like. Lots of ideas here. Not sure why, but I feel like it's time to play c5. I want to get a knight into a better position. That's my main thing here. If he takes the knight, I just trade. Get the bishop out onto f5. If he takes here, we take with the knight. Hmm. I think it's time. He takes with the pawn. That's good, I think. I have knight h4, but it's kind of weird. If I could get my knight out to here, that'd be pretty sick. It's kind of an idea. Maybe he won't take. No, he would take. Gets my queen onto h4, which is like not amazing. Could always run it back. Hmm. I'll just take here. I think we've done like enough damage to. His pawn structure here. Decides to not go for that. Hmm. Interesting. Can go attack his queen. I have check. And he can't do anything about it, so he just won't be able to castle. Hmm. What's better here, the check or attacking the queen? I think the check is better. What's more valuable here, his bishop or my knight? Can you go for the trade here on h4? It's kind of an idea. Open up the f-file. And getting his king here was kind of an interesting idea. Hmm. I don't know. I don't know. There's a lot of ideas here. I might regret that, but we'll see, I guess. The open F file, which is nice. Just bring a rook out to the open file. Can't be too bad, I suppose. He's probably just going to launch all the pawns down, I imagine. I want to get my queen out. What I'm kind of playing for here is to look for this f7 idea and try to win the knight with check here. I want to leave b6 open for the knight, which is why I didn't push up the pawn there. Yeah, I'm looking to win this way. I can win the pawn here. I don't know how he actually protects this pawn. Do I care about the pawn or do I care for like launching attacks on his king? That's the question, I suppose. I don't know how big of a threat this pawn is, you know. Would be nice to get it off the board, though. Since it's the closest thing that he has to a passed pawn. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, I can win the pawn, but I feel like moving the queen over here and trying to get this knight more valuable. Kind of would rather just go h6 to prevent his knight from doing anything funny, but I don't know. A pawn is a pawn. I think I'm just gonna take it. Yeah, I had a feeling that might happen. He's scoping this pawn here. So how do I protect this knight and that at the same time? Probably with the rook. Of a lame spot for the rook. Much rather have him on the open file here, but what are you gonna do? Would have been a pretty deadly move. I'd basically be losing a knight if he got out here to e6. So I think e8, rook e8 had to get played there. I want to go knight c6, but I think he's just going to push up c3. It's going to be kind of a waste of a move. I think the knight's much, much stronger on c4 here. I also want to kick his knight here. It's pretty annoying. I want to send it back to f3. Attacks the knight. I'll just go defend it. I need to think too hard about that. Bring the knight back out here. The position of the knight is just really bad. So I just want to improve it a little bit. The pawn's protected by the queen here, so. I'm gonna go for the trade. If he trades, I get my queen out. Can we just push up too? I like my queen where it is here. I think I'd rather just improve. Push a pawn up in the process. I can live with this. Just closes the pawns. That rook is loose. Maybe I can try to figure out some way to take advantage of that. See, I really want to get my rook out onto b8. But at the same time, yeah, I kind of want to start trading these pawns off and seeing if I can fix these. I have the check here, but what do I really get from it, you know? Am I really gaining from this check? I'm not sure. This A pawn is loose now, so I have to probably go defend it now. I'm gonna go for the trade, huh? I really don't want to do that. I guess he's gonna have a weird pawn structure. I think we have to start getting the king involved here. So we're basically in the end game, so wish me luck. I'm a pawn up. I think it probably would have been a little bit better for me to get a rook out here. Just attack this one pawn. I think getting my rooks out onto this file is going to be key. Or on the third rank, rather. Decides not to take. I don't really want the like triple stack here. I want him to take. Okay. It's a bit awkward. I think he's going to create a passed pawn this way. If I play this rook f3, I think it's a really big mistake. Something like that. He's going to be forced to protect that pawn because otherwise I'm just going to get this rook up the board, I feel. I don't really want to trade here because it puts his pawn onto the g file, and then my king is going to have a hard time running it up these files. Decisions. Maybe that was a bad move. Removing the defender there. I guess I just hung a pawn. Surprised he hasn't pushed this guy up to create the passed pawn. That's going to be hard. It's going to be very difficult. Very, very, very difficult. Kind of just like cracking under the pressure here. He's playing really well for his elo, I feel. 932. I feel like he's playing really well, really well. I still think his best bet is just to sack this pawn here so he can push this pawn up the board. But that's just me. That's just me. But what do I know about endgames? Pretty bad when it comes to endgames. Thinking. Yeah, not too much to think about there. If I was him, I would have just attacked this pawn already, but maybe that's just me. My king's in a really bad spot. I haven't moved my king at all. Probably should have moved my king closer to the center of the board at some point. Yeah, it's a nice move by him. He wins this pawn. I really can't do anything to protect it. Otherwise, I'm losing this one. So, yeah, I'm probably just lost here for me, but... yeah, it's probably lost for me. I guess there's still a chance of running this one with board, but he has so many more pawns. So, it'd be very tough, very tough. Would be a miracle if we win here. Thanks, I guess. Oh, that pawn's a goner anyway. I'm just gonna take up some space in the middle here. Does rook get trapped here? I think it's rook gets trapped here, right? No, he's got to go for the check. Yeah, he's got to go for the check, but then I get the pawn. Yeah, because if I go b2, he can't put his rook anywhere. It's kind of funny. Can I get the pawn though? I can just scoop up his pawns. Kind of funny. That was a very valuable pawn. I guess let's just take all of them. While we're here. Push this one up the board, I suppose. Okay, guys. I have three pawns. How do we not lose here? Okay, check. You want to trade? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so very much. You have made my day. Okay, don't get stalemated here. Okay, if I go here... he's forced there. It could go there. But if he goes here, I can just move my other pawn. Man, if I could stalemate it here, I'm gonna be pissed. Is this stalemate? How do we not stalemate this? We just drop one of the pawns and move the king over or something. Let's think. No. If I move a pawn, it's stalemate, right? Yeah, if I push this pawn, it's stalemate. No, but if I move my king, it's also stalemate. I think I have to just get my boom, boom, boom. How do we do this in a sane way? If I push this pawn, I get stalemated, right? Ugh, endgames. My brain. I think I have to just get my king over here. And drop the pawn. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. Alright. I think I have to give him a legal move here. My brain. I have to get my king right here so I can push this pawn. B2. Yeah, he can't stop this now. Okay. There we go. That was the right sequence of moves, I think. There was probably a better way to do that, but I don't know. I think it's good enough. All I need is one queen to win, right? So. Be pretty straightforward from here. We just do our little king queen checkmate pattern. We'll be good to go. He's really playing this through though. This is his only legal move right here. Yeah. And we bring in Z King, give him the GG. Come on, my boy. You can do this, Mr. Kitty Cat Man from Turkey. Come on, Turkey Kitty Cat Man, let's go. Yeah, well played. Almost stalemate at the end. GG. Yeah, getting the rook over here on A2. And the king on c3 was really quite the move. That was really something. If I push the other pawn when there was two, it was going to be stalemate, I think. It was the pawn on let me see what move it is. Yeah, move 64. Oh, no, actually. Actually, never mind. His king would have been able to escape here. Actually, yeah, forget it. GG. Cool. Good game, man. Yeah, probably a better way to lose, or probably would have been a better way to keep the pawns at the end. But I'm pretty happy with the performance. 6 great moves. I want to see one thing. Moving the king out here. Yeah. Gobbling up the pawns. See, I think what he should have done was just sacked a pawn here so he can run this one up the board, and then I wouldn't have been able to protect the C and A files and defend the E file at the same time. So I think that would have been his best move. It's just giving this one up and making the pass pawn. But that's just me. But anyways, UV Sayut from Turkey. GG. Thanks guys for watching. See you in the next one.